The younger you are, the quicker I pounce. And the older you get, the more tricks I've got. The more naive you stay, the easier I ensnare. And the wiser you are, the more sly I become. The stronger you get, the more I attack. I am sin.
I sound good, I smell good, and I look good. Just when you think you've had enough of me, I draw you back in. Think you can break free from me? Don't be so sure. I am sin.
Some might say I'm only interested in the big things, but that's not the case at all. I love the little white lie. I encourage the second glance at that girl. I hope you take that extra drink. One little compromise. Sometimes that's all I need. I am Sims.
You can't tell nobody about me. Besides, we got a good thing going. You trapped. Nowhere to go and no one to turn to. You actually think people could forgive you? Don't worry, your secret's safe with me. I am Sims.
Man, woman, black, white, young, old, rich, poor, I don't care. I seek all equally. I devour all wholly. It doesn't matter who you are. I am going to kill you. I am Sin.
Just a small three-letter word, but what havoc it has brought upon the earth and all of its inhabitants, especially man. Definitions for this little word are to be without a share in, to miss the mark, to err and be mistaken, to miss or wander from the path of uprightness and honor, or to go wrong, to wander from the law of God and violate God's law, or sin. That which is done wrong, sin, an offense, a violation of the divine law. Collectively, the complex or aggregate of sins committed either by a single person or by many. It isn't a very popular subject among the nation's pulpits anymore, so it's coated over with warm, fuzzy, feel-good messages so as not to offend anyone. It is often practiced but redefined or simply just ignored. There once was a saying, "Give him an inch and he'll take a mile." You can't get any more accurate than that when considering its supersonic growth rate. One little sin by Adam and Eve committed from heeding the father of lies, and look at us now. It got so bad by the time of Noah, God destroyed everyone with a worldwide flood except for Noah and his family, along with designated animals. However, the germ was still there, and in no time at all, it spread like a silent killer again. Sin is like yeast with its effects upon flour, or one lonely rotten apple among a barrel of fresh ones. It spreads and destroys until all is rotten. A sin cannot be reversed by anyone or anything that has already been contaminated by it, and we all have. The scripture says, "For all have sinned and have come short of the glory of God," Romans 3:23. "And for the wages of sin is death," Romans 6:23. See, because of sin, everyone and everything dies. There are no exceptions. As soon as we are born, we begin the process of dying. Think about that. One unique thing about man, though, is that he is an eternal being. Eventually, our body will die, but our soul will live on eternally. The question is where? Luke 12:5, "But I will forewarn you whom ye shall fear. Fear him, which after he hath killed hath power to cast into hell. I say unto you, fear him." Luke 12:5. See, there are two destinations after the body dies. One is hell, the other is heaven. Those without Jesus Christ will go to hell. Those who have Jesus Christ will go to heaven. And no one, I would hope, wants to go to hell. So how do we go to heaven instead after we die? John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Obviously, God has provided the best of heaven, Jesus Christ, so we can be saved from sin and its ultimate end. To rid us from sin, thereby paving our way for us to live eternally with him. Jesus took our sins upon himself at the cross. And those who know him as their Savior and Lord grieve when sin is in their lives, because we know he paid the heaviest price to rid us of those very sins. Am I saying Christians still sin? Oh yes, unfortunately it's so. Romans chapter 7 reminds us of that struggle. When a Christian sins, we do not lose our salvation, but we sure do harm the fellowship with God. When we sin, he tells us to come to him and confess our sins, and he will forgive us and restore that fellowship. John 1:9. See, that's grace. Even though we still sin as Christians, because we remain in these mortal bodies, we don't like it. The whole thing just makes us miserable. I've been miserable many times. What about you? Sin takes on many shapes, but today its most vile forms are being practiced publicly and proudly. There's no point in me rehashing these specifics. I've done that several times before. So let's just say that today nothing is hidden. There is no shame. There is no guilt. There is nothing but sinful man calling down judgment upon their own head because they refuse to repent and forsake their sins. James 4:17, "If anyone then knows the good they ought to do and doesn't do it, it is sin for them." Isaiah 5:20, "Woe to those who call evil good and good evil, who put darkness for light and light for darkness, who put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter." Again, Isaiah 5:20. And this is the verdict. Light is coming to the world, but people love darkness instead of light because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into the light for fear that their deeds will be exposed. And notice those last two verses, John chapter 3, verse 19 and 20. Have you ever wondered why people today get so upset, even vicious, when sin is pointed out? Well, there it is. They don't want their behavior exposed as sin. They don't care to expose their sins. They just don't condemn them. Let's go back to a saying I quoted earlier. Give him an inch and he'll take a mile. Have you noticed that public sins are getting more and more disgusting as the days pass? God said of Noah's day, "The Lord saw how great the wickedness of the human race had become on the earth, and that every inclination of the thoughts of the human heart was only evil all the time." And then he said here, Judges 17:6, "In those days there was no king in Israel, but every man did that which was right in his own eyes." Isn't this describing us in the 21st century to a T? We have reverted to the days of Noah and the times of Israel when there was no leader. Folks, we have no leader except in name only, and our days are drawing short. Those who call for repentance may be ridiculed, but judgment is coming. Much can be said about sin, and none of it is good, except for the good news of Jesus Christ. Look, we may not want to talk about sin, but our barrel of apples is rotten. The yeast has consumed us, and the reaper is on his way. We can be sure our sins will find us out. Numbers 32:23. Anytime now, Jesus will be coming to remove his bride, the church, from this earth. Soon afterward, his judgment will commence. Matthew 4:17. "From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, 'Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.'" And he closes the book by saying, "I come quickly." Revelation 22:7. And once again, thank you for listening. This message was kind of tough. I've got an impact of wisdom due to the sore throat, kind of some crazy stuff going on, but made it through it. You guys, take care of yourself. Take care of your families. God bless you. Please be safe. Thank you.
Cause I can't help falling in love with you.